Yatra is a Sanskrit word for a sacred journey or pilgrimage. Every faith embraces this ancient path of discovery. On Yatra, the journey is also the destination. Every moment has spiritual significance. For over a millennium, for countless travelers, the renowned Buddhist temples and legendary rivers of Southeast Asia have been part of the grand pilgrimage circuit. This is a personal yatra, an exploration of Buddhist wisdom, living traditions, and lost civilizations in Thailand, Laos, and Burma. In Bangkok, the Klang are an elaborate canal system flowing from the Chao Phraya River. Bangkok is a realm of paradox. Moving through this floating world, we travel between future and past. Temple of the Emerald Buddha, Wat Pra Kyaw, adjoins the royal palace. This shrine of empowerment is where the Thai king derives some of his moral and spiritual authority. Beyond the grandiosity of religion, a deeper significance emerges. The opulence is a stratagem. One uses the exaltation of the senses to go beyond the limits of the sense realms. Center of the royal temple complex is the legendary Emerald Buddha. He sits high above the faithful and is honored by continuous chanting of the Heart Sutra. Ever-renewing myths and legends are portrayed in the walls of the temple galleries. Here are depictions from the Hindu Ramayana, which can be seen all through Southeast Asia. This ancient epic precedes Buddhism and even the Thai nation itself. Ram is the royal incarnation of the god Vishnu. Ravana, the ten-headed demon king, has kidnapped Sita, the wife of Ram. This is the divine play of the abduction of innocence by the lord of materialism. Ram, Hanuman, and the great monkey army lay siege to the demon kingdom. Ram battles Ravana and slays him, and rescues Sita from captivity. This epic celebrates the victory of divinity over delusion. This is a spiritual allegory for the regaining of innocence through the annihilation of ego. Wat Po is the oldest temple and monastery in Bangkok. Here are dozens of highly ornamented chedis soaring above the horizontal plane of earthly dualism. They are symbols of vertical transcendence. Wat Po is the abode of the largest reclining Buddha in all of Southeast Asia. The golden Buddha measures 145 feet long and is 5 stories high. This reclining position signifies the dying of the Buddha at 80 years old, and his passing into ultimate nirvana. He is smiling, free of fear, and at peace as he leaves his body for the last time. Within Buddhism, there is no supreme being. Buddha is considered the ultimate expression of a fully evolved human being. He is worshipped as a new paradigm of humanity, but he is not revered as a god. He sits beneath the protective umbrella of the Dharma, the universal law.
Mm-hmm.
About an hour and a half up the Chopraya River is Ayutthaya, the old royal capital of Siam. 33 Siamese kings ruled here. It was once home to over 1 million people. What is left of this once great city are extensive ruins, pagodas, and many active temples, or wats. Within Buddhism, there is an indwelling perfection in every being. Basic understanding in all of Buddhism is that every being possesses Buddha nature. Not everyone is a Buddhist, but everyone is a Buddha to be awakened. This is a temple ceremony where pilgrims take refuge in the Buddha. It acts out in ritual their connection to his being and his teachings, the Buddha Dharma. Chiang Mai is the largest city in the north and home to many of the oldest temples and monasteries in Thailand. In this wat, pilgrims hold a string connected to the temple Buddhas. This symbolizes the transmission of the Dharma. The life story of the Buddha is told in every age. Here, it is depicted in the style of the Thai court. Siddhartha Gautama was born the only son of a king of Nepal. His father was fearful the young prince would become a spiritual wanderer. The king provided every sense delight imaginable. Music, elaborate finery, courtiers, and courtesans. Siddhartha was married to a lovely and kind princess. The palace was insulated from every form of human misery. Yet Siddhartha felt compelled to see what was beyond. On his first three trips outside the palace walls, he confronted, for the first time, sickness, old age, and death. He saw how everyone was very fearful of these changes. On his fourth trip, he saw a wandering forest yogi who was not afraid and was free. Inspired, Siddhartha left the security of the palace. He set out to discover the origins of suffering and the end of fear. This is a village of the Karen people near Chiang Mai. The Buddha image is a brilliant mirror reflecting one's innate perfection. The large golden icons of the Buddha are empty inside. This represents the absence of a solid and opaque self. Buddha is the embodiment of radiant wisdom, the luminous transparency of being. The Dharma River has its origins in the unmanifested. It arises from the formless. It spontaneously appears from the steamy wellsprings of life events. With the freedom of moving water, the Dharma flows into every aspect of life. This is a ceaseless stream of gravity and grace. The Dharma River flows through time as an unstoppable force of transforming change. This is the mighty Mekong River. It courses more than 3,000 miles through China, Laos, Cambodia, Thailand, and Vietnam, and finally into the South China Sea. Mekong is the life giver and sustainer of all who dwell on it. Flows effortlessly into ever-renewing ages of innocence. Thank you. Paku Caves are a traditional pilgrimage site. The caves are home to more than 4,000 Buddha figures. Many of the Buddhas have their arms held by their sides in the very distinctive Lao Buddha posture of calling for rain. The statues were left here over the centuries as devotional offerings. In Buddhism, there have been many Buddhas in the ages before Gautama Buddha. Infinite beings, infinite Buddhas. Infinite beings, infinite Buddhas. The river flows from the source to the ocean. Every being arrives spontaneously in the world, endlessly moving on a river of continuous change. The currents of the river become gentle as we stop clinging, grasping, and holding on. Within this lifetime, each being may learn to open to the flow of the present moment. This river of the eternal now. The great perfection, vast and limitless. Wang Prabang has been largely untouched by war or the neglects of time. This sleepy Shangri-La in the Mekong River Valley was long the royal capital of Laos and its spiritual center. Wat Jang Tong was built for the king in 1560. This temple complex remained under royal patronage for more than 400 years until the kingdom ended in 1975. The temple's low overlapping roofs sweep skyward. This blending of the simple and the complex is a revelation of the sacred architecture of Luang Prabang. On the east wall of the temple is a giant glass mosaic of the Tree of Life. This variety of mirror mosaics is unique to Luang Prabang. Sparkling reflections of ambient light. These golden bas-reliefs are on the sides of a funereal temple containing some of the ashes of former Lao kings and queens. The gilded panels portray scenes from the Hindu Ramayana, which is ever present throughout Southeast Asia. Here, we see the main players of this Indian epic, dwelling in the afterlife. Arising out of the consuming flames, we see Rama, Sita, Hanuman, and other members of this cosmic lila, or divine play. There is a remarkably serene quality to the awakened faces. The half-opened eyes show an ecstatic reverie. Their postures display an ease of beatific sensuousness. This work is a celebration of divine love and redemption over death and loss.
Come on.
A statue of the lineage founder is returned back into Wat Mai. He was taken outside for fresh air, sunlight, bathing, and veneration. These are the famous golden bas-reliefs on the temple's veranda wall. These visual parables were created to instruct a pre-literate culture in spiritual values. This extraordinary work details the everyday life of harmony in traditional Luang Prabang. The wall carvings also depict the last incarnation of the Buddha before his ultimate enlightenment as Gautama Buddha. He is shown as a king, a husband, a father, and a healer. The Lao Buddhas are traditionally shown with the flame of wisdom at the top of their heads. This is the crown of enlightenment. This temple is a unique refuge for over 1,000 Buddha figures. They were brought here over the centuries. They came from temples and personal shrines that were destroyed or relocated. This is a Buddha orphanage, a Dharma rest home. Many of these Buddhas are more than 400 years old. They are left undusted as a means of preserving the patina of gold leaf covering them. Many of the Lao Buddhas have their arms extended outwards. This is known as the stop fighting position. During the Vietnam War, more than 2 million tons of bombs were dropped on Laos. This trauma was followed by a civil war, the disappearance of the royal family, and the total takeover by a xenophobic regime, the Petet Lao. Laos was fully cut off from the outside world until very recently. The Buddhist community, or Sangha, is helping to re-establish the traditional ways of peace and harmony.
Dazzles.
taking root in the cold darkness of unknowing. This flower is nourished by the deep, rich mud of our discontent. Its long stem rises up through the still, dark water. The swollen lotus bud opens to the light, unfolding a blossom, pure and radiant. Wedagon Pagoda sits atop the highest hill at the center of Rangoon, the capital of Burma. Rising more than 30 stories, the pagoda is believed to enshrine 8 hairs of the Buddha. Royal patrons and wealthy merchants generously endowed Shwedagon through the centuries for their own religious merit. The ultimate manifestation of the living spirit, however, came from the inspired hearts and minds of thousands of anonymous artisans. Once one of the most prosperous nations in Asia. Now, after colonialism and 40 years of military rule, it is one of the poorest countries in the world. Yet, at Shwedagon, everyone can share in the splendor and magnificence. The pagoda is the most esteemed place in the entire nation. After climbing hundreds of stairs, pilgrims arrive on a 15-acre circular marble platform. They pray and meditate at the scores of shrines and pavilions circling the perimeter. Shwedagon is a classical Buddhist stupa. It has been a place of continual worship for more than 2,000 years. Pilgrims still circumambulate the stupa and perform the same holy rituals the faithful did more than 2 millennia ago. Thank you. After praying, pilgrims strike large gongs to share the merit with all living beings. Faithful make offerings at the shrine representing the day of the week they were born. One pours a cup of water over the Buddha's head for each year that one has been alive. This ritual reminds each celebrant of the timeless flow of their own unique and precious human birth. Buddha is often portrayed as a homeless wanderer, yet he was born a crown prince who was raised in a palace. Being is classless. Being is in abundance. Being is noble. Buddha is being. Buddha lived to be 80 years old, yet he is always portrayed as a young man. Being is ageless. Being is always fully alive. Burmese Buddha images sometimes appear androgynous. This implies a freedom from the limits of gender. Buddha nature is neither male nor female. The enlightened one is the embodiment of radiance. Being is genderless. Being is simply the living presence. Original nature, free of conditioning, free of an imagined self, Buddha is being. Sangha is the community of the faithful. Here the monks and lay people take refuge in the three jewels of Buddhism: the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha.
So what, you got it?
The Buddha is always portrayed with extremely long earlobes. These were caused by wearing the very heavy ornamental earrings of a prince. This kind of disfigurement was an unmistakable sign of royalty. The Buddha gave up the earrings, along with the privileges of his caste. The conditioning of separateness, the lonely exile of the fixed self, is one's own personal disfigurement. Sharing the precious human birth, bringing crown and heart together. All are born to a great and noble calling. Arising from this formless mist, the lost Buddhist civilization of Pagan. A thousand years ago, at the start of the last millennium, this magnificent fantasy of form emerged. This dreamscape in central Burma still contains over 4,000 temples, pagodas, and stupas. It's been said that if you took the medieval cathedrals of Europe and put them in one place, it would look like Bagan. A purifying flame surrounds the doors and windows of every temple. A symbolic burning away of ill will, impurities, and negative forces. For over two centuries, Bagan became the thriving center of Theravadan Buddhism. Some temples are still invested for active worship by people who live in the adjacent towns and villages. The Burmese often wear sandalwood paste. This acts as a cooling sunblock and is also used as makeup. Of all the magnificent temples of legendary Bagan, the Ananda Temple is thought to be the most beautiful. Built in the first century of the last millennium, the Ananda Temple was completed in 1091. This is one of the Buddhas of the four directions. They are positioned on each interior side of the Ananda Temple. They represent the four major Buddhas of this world within the Theravadan belief. The last Buddha, the one of this age, is understood to be Gautama Buddha. Shown here, he is positioned in the sanctuary to watch the sun set in the west. These Buddhas are nearly 1,000 years old. Faithful pay homage to the Buddhas at each of the four shrines. The golden Buddha of the south has gazed with loving kindness over the sacred scape of Bagan for nearly 1,000 years. The essential teaching of the Buddha was about the undeniable truth of impermanence. Not to cling to the things of this world, as they are transitory, brittle, and fleeting. At Bagan, the temples were originally covered with white ornamental plaster carving and brightly gilded spires. Nearly 1,000 years of flash floods, earthquakes, and dust storms have reduced these structures to the exposed terracotta bricks. The temples and stupas of Bagan were built by kings and wealthy benefactors for their own religious merit, a way to perpetuate their legacy, and as insurance for an auspicious rebirth. This zeal for endless building led to unintended consequences. For 240 years, the brick kilns were red hot, fired by the diminishing local wood, and finally eliminating all of the forests. This deforested landscape became waterless and barren, and Bagan was ultimately abandoned. Though one should live 100 years without comprehending how all things rise and pass away, yet better indeed is a single day's life of one who does comprehend how all things rise and pass away. The Buddha. Each generation flows into the next. This ever-renewing river of the human spirit. This is a local school funded by Western Buddhists who have practiced meditation at a nearby monastery. Just as one would look upon a bubble, just as one would look upon a mirage, if a person thus looks upon the world, the king of death sees him not, the Buddha. Sagaing Hills, across the river from sleepy Mandalay. This place is home to thousands of monks and nuns. Here, they practice the profound Burmese meditation tradition of Vipassana. Existence is impermanent, that change is finally its own refuge, and not to be feared. This impermanence is not loss, but a continuous flow. The river is never the same. It is unceasing movement. In Buddhism, there is the enduring concept of the other shore. Pilgrims journey across the turbulent and cleansing waters of the river of life. This signifies the passing from samsara, or illusion, to nirvana, the ultimate truth. The other shore is free of desire, craving, and dissatisfaction. Crossing this river is both the journey and the destination.